What would you like him to stand?
And electrical.
I'm Grant Smith. I'm doing design, modeling, and fabrication.
I'm Kevin Smith. I'm doing modeling and fabrication.
So, a little background about single main. First and foremost, we're a little different than the rest of the other senior project groups. Our project is fully funded and sponsored by single main. Single main is a company in France in a town that I can't say, but they are a manufacturing company that is over 350 years old, one of the oldest companies actually known as man, and they are one of the leaders and biggest companies in manufacturing in the entire world. They dive into thousands of different products, and the specific company, a specific branch of Saint Cobain that we work for is in Hollywood, and they work with ceramics. So they do things as like abrasive materials, and that's kind of what we are diving into. So, our problem is that Saint-Gobain has a specific material. Now, because we are working with a specific company, we had actually signed an NDA, which states that we can't actually tell you the product that we are using. But judging by our design and the way, hopefully, that we tell you guys what we're doing, you can get the basis of what the project is. So they're a ceramic company, so they make ceramics. So we are taking one of their powders that they made in the facility and transferring it. So when they do their special system, they break the system up into different parts and have specific micron sizes of each individual item or product that they're using. We're specifically taking one of the products that they produce and transferring it from their containers that it comes in that they make it with and putting it into jars so it is able to be shipped out to the customer. This jar has to be put at a specific weight, a very specific weight, which we'll dive into later. So you're thinking, oh, this is a pretty poor area to put your model right away, which it is. But we're trying to, you know, develop a thought process, get the gears going, and the head ready about what actually it looks like. So we have our project broken up into a few basic steps. So our first one is the hopper itself. The hopper itself will hold all the material into a container, and Brandon will get into later. Next, we have the feeder tray, which will actually feed the material down to the jar. And we have the PLC control, which Seth will dive into about what actually happens. The vibrators themselves will control everything. And lastly, is the frame itself. The real way we design this entire system is that we want it to be interchangeable. So when we get the frame designed perfectly, exactly the way we want it to, and we have the hopper and the feeder tray go inside the frame. That way, say, maybe 6 months or 15 years down the road, if the hopper or the feeder tray for some reason break or become abraded somehow, they can be replaced and the new ones can be put in. So, for the solution of the problem ourselves, as you can see from our last model, we have designed a system that can easily feed the material through a system controlled by a PLC. The PLC itself will control the vibrations, and the vibrations will then lead the flow of the material down the path to the jars. The exact flow will be at the end. We have a load cell at the end that has the jar placed on top of to measure the exact weight we need.
So as for our mechanical requirements, the system must fit within a 9-foot by 5-foot by 6-foot footprint. And the system cannot use compressed air, so everything must be electrical. The system should be able to fill 50 jars in 24 hours to 20,000 with a tolerance of 2 carats. The system supply hopper should be able to be filled safely and ergonomically. The system should also limit the contamination into the supply hopper and the jars. And the system should limit the amount of dust created from the process of the powder falling into the jars.
So our mechanical specification, we
design is equal to 100-foot material work. The model will fit within the floor plan of their accessible area on their plant floor. It will be fully enclosed and prevent any dust contamination from the product being through. I mean, it's very careful that any contamination, any dust will be product lost. The entire system, the material will be touching, has to be stainless steel. We will use the combination 316 and all the 304. So this is our overall design. We have a 7.3 gallon hopper that you'll load the material into the hopper, which will then be outputted onto a linear feeder tray. That feeder tray will either be rotational vibration or linear vibrations. There'll be two vibrators, one on the feeder tray and one on the hopper. The scale will then be on the table with a jar on it. So the PLC will control the output, I mean, will gain output of the scale and control the feeder tray output into the jar. And it'll shut the vibration off when the scale hits certain weight. So, in our testing right now, we are currently deciding what type of vibrations to put on the linear feeder tray. So we are, right now we are testing a rotational vibration, which uses the motor with counterweight on to create just a sinusoidal wave between the high and low vibrations, or they also make a linear vibration device, which will make vibrations parallel to the bottom of the tray, which is more of a displacement method than a vibrational method. So we are going to have this tray fabricated up. We can use this with either vibration method for the best movement in maintaining the flow rate. The reason we have this tray is to vary the flow rate coming out of the hopper, because if this material, one with material weighs 133 pounds, so it's a very dense material. So we are using this tray to mainly just control the flow rate into the jar, which is on the scale. The jars have to be filled with a 2-carat tolerance. The carats are 0.04 grams, so it's a very, very tight tolerance to reach. Therefore, the flow rate must be controlled over a very steady. Our current dimensions right now are 60 inches high by 54 inches long and 36 inches wide. This is our rotational vibrator. We will be implementing two vibration sources, one on the hopper, so the material will not come inside the hopper, which means it will not build up. There will not be any dead spots within the hopper, so all material goes on to the linear feeder tray. For the hopper, we did the math and found this vibration. This vibrator is a rotational vibrator. The force on it is there, and therefore you can add and subtract the amount of force this vibrator implies into the hopper. It has a maximum force of 20 pounds. To move 10 pounds of material, it requires 1 pound of force.
So this is our hopper. So far we've purchased the hopper from Toledo Metal Spinning. We chose to get the hopper metal spun because it's cheaper. And the hopper holds a capacity of 7.3 gallons. And when it's fully loaded, it has a weight of 150 pounds. And the material that it's made out of is 316 stainless steel.
So our electrical requirements are that the components need to be held in a NEMA 4 IP6X approved panel. And this panel keeps out any dust from getting into the electrical components and messing them up. The vibrator needs to be controlled by the PLC. There needs to be an emergency power cutoff indicator, along with lights to signal this different stages within the cycle, and then data acquisition from the PLC for Saint Gobain to record the data, and then the PLC should be able to be controlled by the vibrator. And then the specifications are, so for the PLC we're using an Allen Bradley Micrologix 1100 series PLC. PLC needs to communicate with the vibrator on the hopper, and the PLC communicates with the load cell to shut off the vibrator when it reaches the appropriate capacity.
So here we have a process flow diagram. What's going to happen is first an operator is going to load the powder into the supply hopper, and a bottom will go down to the load cell, which the operator will most likely tear the weight up. It might be controlled by the PLC, we're still working that out. Once the operator gets the start button, the vibrator vibrator on the hoppers first to add power to the chute, which will then also be vibrating, and that just pretty much keeps going until the bottle reaches, when the load cell reaches 4,000 grams, at which point both vibrators shut off and a red LED light turns on and flashes to let the operators know that your bottle is empty. This is the code we use for testing. It's just a PLC code. It has a start button, stop button. We latch that with a bit so that once the start button, which is a momentary switch, is hit, it stays on until we have the stop, stop, go, press, two separate buttons for that. Through testing, we found that if you originally had not the subtract, but just the PLC's reading coming in, so PLC has an analog in, which takes a DC voltage and converts it to a just a number, I guess. So we had that originally, but it wasn't as accurate as we wanted, so we found if we switched it and subtracted what 4,000 grams gave us, which is that 118 that we've seen in the subtract plot, from, or we subtracted the number of PLC from that 118, we actually get a better reading, which in the third line, I guess it's the second line, it's the third line, it says greater than, as long as our reading is greater than that 113, or I guess, yeah, it says 113. The green LED is lit, which in this case is simulating the vibrator, and then once we're at that one or less than one number, the vibrator would stop and the dynamic LED would be lit. This was our testing. You'll have to take our word that between 0 and 4,000, the green LED was still lit. We were supposed to get a video, we didn't have time to actually end up getting that. But once we reached 4,000, under the red LED was lit, simulating that the vibrator would shut off and the process was done. This was our circuit schematic for testing. In the actual final product, everything will be controlled by AC, but for testing, the LEDs are obviously controlled by a 5-volt DC source. Our scale has output of serial signals. We had to get an adapter to convert that to analog to use. It's connected, has to be connected to the I0/4 port, because that's the analog port for the actual physical PLC. There's only two of them, so you have to use those specifically for your analog inputs. We have a video. We also got a vibrator for via the PLC. So this is actually Dr. Zhu, so thank you Dr. Zhu for modeling for us. He's gonna flip the switch and the vibrator will turn on. Have a video to show that.
Yep.
So maybe it doesn't come through clearly there, but the vibrator is very strong, so we might have to cut that down a bit.
So management. So our budgets are for electrically, our expenses are, well, consist of the buttons, the start stop buttons. Okay, and then the lights, wires, vibrators, frequency controllers, PLC, which is given to us by Dr. Zhu in previous projects, and then the AC power distribution block, and that adds up to a total of $1,300.
As for the mechanical budget, so far we've purchased the hopper, which came in at a price of $215. And the rest of the parts, we have a rough estimate of about how much they will cost, totaling to $1,740. For our overall budget, as Q said, we plan to spend around $1,315 for electrical parts, $1,740 for mechanical, coming into about $3,050. And Saint-Gobain, as we said earlier, is funding our project, giving us a max budget of $4,000. Which we plan on not getting too close to. So we plan to only use the Wilkes Fund for emergencies. So we should have about $1,500 left over.
So what we've accomplished so far is that we've been able to get the PLC to communicate with the load cell and the vibrator, which is the first step, and actually getting the entire system to work. We've actually purchased the hopper. When we purchased the hopper, when it came in, since it was metal spun, the bottom of the hopper actually doesn't have a hole cut into the end of it. So we have to do the calculations for flow rate to find exactly what is movement for the material to flow out. We modeled a quick tray, as Brandon said before, we are still unsure whether you want to cut us off or just keep going. Okay, so the tray and the frame we both modeled so far, but due to constrictions and whatnot, we don't exactly know the exact specifications of what we want the tray to look like, due for budget reasons. So we still need to work on that. So, as like I just said before, we have to work on the tray a little bit more because of budget reasons. We found one that was $1,700, and we can't really use that one because that cuts into almost half of our entire budget. So we have to look into whether or not we can get it outsourced and just built for a cheaper price. And then we have to, once we get the next tray in, then we will order the second vibrator and have the PLC communicate with that vibrator for the future tray. And that's it. We have, like I said before, we had Samuel Bain sponsoring us and funding us for this whole thing. Quinlan works at PSA Systems, and when we go to build the frame, they are going to donate or help us with the tubing for the frame to build it there.
Questions? Dr. B.
So, can you go back to your second, please? Are you bolting it to the floor at all? How are you going to keep it from?
We have
vibration there, obviously, the frame. All of our vibration will be on our mount. The frame will not have any vibration to it because steel is going to be mounted on an ankle, so steel will not have any vibration transferring to it that would throw off the frame.
You may also want to look at the cross bracing of the frame, too, instead of just having the hosts.
This is a very rough design.
We went to St. Germain for a meeting, and when we went there, they honestly didn't actually have a place for this to go yet. They were kind of like, oh, it's going to go in this room, but the room is full of stuff. So they were like, yeah, kind of just model it and like design it, and then we're going to want you to change it. So we're you know, we have to listen to them.
So quick comment here. That stainless steel frame, that's going to be heavy.
Yeah, the frame is going to be out of this frame. Everything the material touches has to be stainless.
So, in that case, I would recommend maybe looking at an 80-20 frame. It gives you a lot more design flexibility. You can take the thing down to bits and put it back together to transport it. I think that that would make your life significantly easier.
That frame currently is 2 inch by 1.5 inch 11 gauge tubing, so fairly light duty tubing for the weight. I mean, the hopper's going to weigh maximum 140 pounds, plus the linear feet here will be about 50 pounds, plus the scale.
I'm just giving you an average tension precision, because even if it doesn't weigh a lot, I think they won't be. And just a quick question, you said your vibrator is bringing 20 pounds of
vibration.
I'm kind of lacking some physical intuition. What does that actually mean?
You need 10 pounds of vibrational per kilo back to that slide.
I'm talking about what does X pounds of vibrational force mean? He's saying the frequency.
You have to size how big your hopper is to vibrational force and the flat on the hopper. We don't want any more coning of materials in the hopper. We want to be able to break all the material loose so it'll stick to the side of the hopper. So therefore all of it can be fed through the hopper properly. So by sizing the vibrator to the maximum weight of the hopper, we can regularly and eliminate any chance of coning.
I think what he's getting to is the way you're reporting vibration, 20 pounds.
The 20 vibrators are measured by how many force, by their pound force, which is equivalent then to the maximum operating.
I think you may want to also give the information like what frequency, plus. Yeah, that's what I was getting at is irrelevant on your project, what does a 20 pound vibrator mean?
I can break it down for
you. Yeah.
It goes into how fast is the product going to fall off the end of the chute for the jar? Because you have a feedback control system here that's going to be controlled by this PLC. You have a very tight tolerance that you have to satisfy for your weight for this, for filling this. And so, do you have any control over this of that